Should eat something, man. You look like shit.
Thank you.
Fuck you!
What? Well, I'm sorry. Come on. I have all this stuff. The party doesn't have to end.
Save it. What happened to your knee?
Baseball. It's all fucked up.
Pro?
I was going pro when it happened. I was good. Don't you worry. I can still throw a mean fastball.
Yeah, I bet.
Life is fucked up.
You got some cash?
Hey, man, don't fuck with my wallet. Come on.
Yeah, I gotta get some gas, you know? I gotta drive all the way back to Gallup. And, you know, you said you were from around.
Come on, give it back to me.
See, it's just a 20.
What the fuck, man? Are you a fucking hustler?
You're wasted. Kind of funny, you know? Thought you were the hustler? But if you were, you'd have your shit together.
Wait. I'm sorry, all right? You don't have to go, do you? Huh?
Yeah.
Doctor?
Mark, come on, I got customers. Mark.
Dr. Navarro says you'll be okay.
God's not through with me yet, huh? That I'm supposed to say.
You have no insurance, Mark. You can't freeload here. Good. And you're not coming to my house.
Fine. I want to hear you preaching it.
Look, I've said it all already.
Wash your hands of me, brother.
You're amazing even like this. You're so smart. Maybe that's why you keep outsmarting yourself. How's that working for you, Mark?
I don't want to hear about it.
I'm done with this. I'm done with you. So your choices are real clear.
Why are you doing this to me?
The Tillets are willing to speak with you. You might want to consider their generosity.
There is nothing wrong with me.
Then why do you keep trying to kill yourself?
You brought Mom, didn't you?
No.
Liar. Mom! Mom!
If she wanted to see you, she'd be in here.
Fuck you, Paul! All right, fuck you! Why'd you bring her, huh? You prick? Why'd she come here, you fucking cane? Mom! Fuck you, Paul! Fuck you! Mom! 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 Ah! Mom! Fuck! Thank you.
be all right. We'll be waiting. All right. Okay, we'll see you then. Paul Malloy. He's gonna bring him over late this afternoon. He's willing to pay for 2 months.
Can he come earlier? You know I like us both to be at the table for dinner.
Yeah, I know, but
we sure could use this, what with Adam graduating and all.
I thought you said he had a cocaine problem.
Oh, I can handle that.
I know. Just concerns me.
They're all God's children.
Praise the Lord. You don't like this bracelet?
No, no, I mean, it's very pretty. It's petty.
I just get a little jealous whenever I see you wearing something that Jack gave you.
He had good taste. But I love you. Jesus Christ can change your life. We know from his word that he allows our struggles so that his power might be revealed in us and so that he will receive glory. I can think of no better life than to be a vessel for God's glory and power. Not about coming to grips with who I am. It's about coming to grips with who he is, and that's a life worth living. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We ask that you still keep Henry Cooper in your prayers. Scott will be visiting him later today, and Scott, we want to be sure you take our love to your father.
I will, thank you. Praise Jesus.
Well, as we all know, today is Adam's last day.
Never make it.
And we want to wish him Godspeed, give him a loving send-off as he ventures out into the world, a beacon of light and hope, another source of pride for Genesis House. Oh, let us gather together in his name. Amen.
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 Yes, of course. Adam, would you like to say the steps for us one last time?
Sure. We admit we are powerless over our homosexuality and our lives are unmanageable. We've come to believe that a power greater than ourselves can restore us to sanity.
Have you been here long?
No, half hour or so. You missed a good turkey pot pie. You okay, Dad?
When you have it back.
Do you want me to leave?
Yeah.
Okay, are you all right? Can I get you something?
I'm fine.
I went by the store. Hector says hi, business is good.
Roofs need fixing. I told you that years ago.
Yes. I'm gonna graduate soon.
That place.
Yeah. And I'm gonna move back into the house. I'm gonna make it real nice for when you come home.
Your mother should be alive. I'm so proud of you, son. Proud you beat the devil.
Yes, sir.
Lydia, that smells wonderful. Jude, fork on the left.
I'll be in my room.
Oh, Lester, you're up. Ted's waiting.
I'm always so nervous when a new guy comes in.
And look at me, I'm the Pillsbury Doughboy. I know. I'm supposed to worry about things like that, you know, being attractive. Except to women. Praise Jesus and pass those contraceptives. I like it when I make you laugh at things you don't want to. They're the best kind. Thing is, I don't fit in here. Or anywhere else, never did. My father told me the stork dropped me down the wrong chimney, so start there. I was three, it was Halloween. And my father caught me putting on my mother's makeup. I mean, she thought it was cute, but he gave me a good whipping. Next Halloween, he made me go as Superman. Anyway, I just hated the fact that he pawned me off for somebody else's problem. I'm glad I'm here. You really listen. It means a lot to me to see that people can be happy. I didn't used to think that. I need to think that.
Paul, it's good to see you again.
Ted, Gail, thanks for doing this. I hope it helps. Come on, Mark. Mark, Gail, and Ted Tillett. Gail and Ted, this is my brother, Mark.
Mark, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Yes, welcome. Welcome to Genesis. Sure you won't stay for dinner, Paul?
I can't, I gotta.
I understand.
Well, God bless you. Thanks for everything.
God bless you too, Paul.
Good luck, Mark.
Give our best to your mother.
All right, then. Why don't you come in when you're ready? There's a place for you at the table. I'll get you a duffel.
Got it.
Good. I'll show you to your room. Okay, I'll introduce you to the fellas. Jude. That's Mark.
Mark?
That's Jude. And this is Dustin.
Hello.
Dustin. Legs.
Oh.
Come on. You're rooming right here with Lester Barkley. Lester's a good guy. You'll like him.
I have to have a roommate?
Everybody does, except fifth phasers.
What is this, Scientology or something?
No. Fifth phasers are men who've been here the longest who've accomplished what they set out to do.
Whatever.
Dinner is ready. Would you get the boys then?
I'll get them. Mark, welcome to Genesis.
You can add your touch anytime.
Oh, I don't have one. I didn't get that gene.
Well, you have the genes the Lord designed for you, and you have the choice to live in his image. Just talk to Lester before you do anything. I'm sure he'll be fine with it.
Get a key for that door?
No. We don't lock our doors. We have nothing to hide here. You going to eat tonight?
No.
And please come to my office so I can get you started. I'll give you a moment. Jude? Dinner, now. When are you gonna get that haircut?
Samson had long hair.
Well, you're not Samson.
Jesus had long hair.
Dinner.
Hi. Scott Cooper.
You must be Mark.
Yep.
Welcome. You come to dinner? Jesus, that all you people think about? Food? Well, at mealtime, sure.
You're Mark.
Fortunately,
Bill Pryor. I'm the fifth phaser.
Yeah.
That means I'm in charge when Ted and Gale aren't around.
Great.
Yeah. A lot of the guys, they peak at level 2 or 3. You know why?
You know, Bill. Why?
Because they're weak.
Mark? Could you please come in?
Dear Lord, thank you for this food. Bless the hands that prepared it. Bless it to our use and us to your service. And make us ever mindful of the needs of others. Through Christ our Lord we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Gracias, Lydia.
We are a Christian recovery program specializing in sexual brokenness. And in addition to the golden rule, there's a few others we expect you to follow. No caffeine, no nicotine. Meals are at 6, 12, and 5:30. And the second Sunday of each month is reserved for fasting and reflection. Group meetings are 6 days a week, 10 a.m. They're mandatory. And Sundays we attend morning services at the local church. As far as addiction issues go, Ted has 9 years of victory over drugs and alcohol. Praise the Lord. And he'll be a great resource for you. We expect modesty in language, behavior, and dress. Daily chores are assigned at the beginning of each week, and they include cleaning, yard work, kitchen duty.
We don't get to make license plates.
Mark. This is a choice. Your choice. Do you understand? You're free to go at any time. But here's the good news. If you are ready to make a change, you are in the right place.
Y'all just do this for free, huh? Come on, who pays for this?
Well, actually, your brother paid for 2 months for you here.
Bill, let it be.
Mark, your brother cares about you.
Oh, of course he paid. You know, I don't need anything from him, all right? Not anymore, you got that? He's gonna take this, and he's gonna hold it over me just like it is everything else. Well, I'm not gonna let him do it.
Well, I think you should spend the night here and pray over
it. I don't wanna fucking pray!
Well, then think. In the morning, we'll talk again. And in the meantime, please watch your language.
Jesus Christ. Sorry. Can I go to my room now?
Yes, but check with Scott after dinner. He may have a project he needs your help with.
Gale sent me up here to see if you needed a hand. Looks like you got everything under control there, Big Bird. Cigarette around here.
No nicotine allowed. But if you don't mind, I could use a hand.
Not bad. Whatever, looks like you're almost done to me.
Do you think he'll make it?
He's got no place left to go but the streets. He's too spoiled to make it out there. I figure we got 2 days before he decides to leave.
What if we don't take his brother's money?
Gail.
What if we could call Pastor Thompson or the family council?
No, no, we tapped them out already. Besides, I got an election coming up.
So we've got 2 days to make an impression.
Well. You made an impression on me in less than 5 minutes. Hey.
I love you, but I can't.
Okay. Let me make you happy.
about the snoring. But they say it's often the result of an unconscious desire to alienate a predator.
You are not fucking serious.
No, I'm not. Look, if you're gonna bolt, go around the front. That way you don't pass Ted and Gail's room.
The room's all yours.
Guardian of this holy abode?
First nights are tough.
What happened to no nicotine?
Progress, not perfection.
I won't say anything if you won't. Oh, sorry, it's not stronger, but it's addictive if that's what you're looking for. Are you all right?
What?
Maybe better stay the night. Take off tomorrow. Won't get a ride at this hour anyway. There's not everybody on the road.
How long you been here?
About 5 minutes. Couldn't sleep.
I mean this place.
Yeah, I know what you mean. 5 months.
You've been here 5 months. You need these more than I do.
Hey, are you okay? Are you sure you're all right?
Fine.
You look pale.
How the fuck can you tell it's dark? Shit.
Hey.
Shit. Ted! Ted!
Just breathe. Just breathe.
Standard panic attack. We could have kept him another day or two in the detox.
No, I'm not going back to a goddamn hospital.
If he's got insurance, he'd have to go to county jail.
Mark. So, what do you think? Can you handle this? Well, you're the expert, right? Maybe I should call your brother.
No, he's not my fucking guardian. I decide.
Then decide. It's here or County General.
Doc, thanks for coming. I'll show you out.
Yeah, thanks, Doc. Night. Night. Mark? Mark? Now you listen to me. You want to get better. And that's the beginning. I've seen miracles happen here. Now you just give it some time and you let your miracle happen. You're going to start to see things differently. I promise you that.
I don't want it to be this way.
I know. You are loved here, Mark. You are loved.
My dad died of liver failure. Jesus couldn't save him from alcoholism, so I guess that's where I got it from, right? So, speaking of, these past 3 weeks have been a bitch. But, Lester's cool. You make me laugh. But Randall, man, he's good for a lame joke or two every now and then. I'll tell you one time I got about as far as the porch, though. Something made me stop. I'm sure none of you are familiar with what that feels like, right? I think there's something to this place. In the past, I would have been another county by now, for sure. Hey, man, I'm sorry.
For what?
Well, I should have probably thanked you for helping me out that first day.
Helping you pass out, you mean?
It's
okay, don't worry.
Little hard feelings?
What we're all trying to do here is hard enough. I don't need my ego getting in the way.
Do you really think this shit works?
Guess it depends on what you mean by works. How do you want to live? I've had plenty of experience doing it my way. Now I can try it someone else's.
Hey, fellas, how about giving me a hand with all those birdhouses?
Oh, I'd live for it, Ted.
Good. Let's get to it.
I still say we should charge more than $10 for these things.
It's for charity, Mark, not QVC.
What?
Maybe we should charge more for yours. Just a thought.
I really like Maxine a lot. We've been going out almost a year now. Can you believe it? Feels right. Never thought I'd get here. But after 5 years, I had to accomplish something, you know? I'm result-oriented. Oh, maybe that's not the best way to put it. I thought of asking her to marry me. But I haven't said anything yet. I need to be making more money first. She can't move in here. I sure don't want to live with her mother. That's the only option right now. But I'll make it work somehow. But if I'm going to be totally honest, and I didn't include this in my last accountability report, this new guy, Mark, I'm having thoughts.
I know. That's okay. That happens. But you said if it's not talked out, it could be acted out. Now, I trust myself not to act on it. But that's stopped the thoughts. And I feel guilty with Maxine.
That may be why I forgot to include it in the report. That's why I'm telling you to keep that as far away as possible. Well, as far as my drinking, I'm sober 5 months since that last time. So I've got a good handle on that. All in all, things are getting better every day. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, I think closer to the side right here.
Randall, how we doing?
That's it. Coming in now. You can turn it off unless you want to flood in here.
I should turn off the water.
I got it.
Coming down?
Yeah.
Okay.
Never tell you I'm afraid of heights.
Don't worry, I'm not. I'm right here. You're good. No, just.
It's an inappropriate touch now.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, that ain't your fault.
Let's go, Dustin. Careful, boys.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you.
How long have you been standing there?
Oh, a few seconds.
I thought you were still up on the roof with Mark.
No, we found the leak. It's in the flashing at the base of the skylight.
You two seem to be having fun.
You need help with those?
No, I'm fine. I'm almost finished.
What color is that?
It was what?
The stripes on your shirt. What color would you say they are?
I don't know. They're red. You know, Gail, that night on the porch with Mark.
That night what?
Well, I'd given him a cigarette. I haven't had one since, but I think that's what made him sick anyway. I'm sorry for that.
Well, thank you for being honest, Scott.
Is it okay if I take the van, go to my dad's?
You going alone?
Oh, yeah.
Ted has keys.
Hey, my man.
Oh, it's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Hector.
Sup, sup.
I got a small leak in the roof of Genesis. Need some flashing, gotta fix up the skylight.
Want me to grab it? So I just talked to your dad, man. You sounded good.
Yeah, he's tough that way.
Nice to see they're still letting you out over there, huh?
What'd you get for finding Jesus?
Amen to that.
I mean, being like this never felt okay for me. Or if it did, it was a feeling that was over so fast I can't remember it. Maybe my mom had been around. I think when she died, my dad sort of stopped living too, except through me. Then when my dad found out I was gay, he acted like I'd died too, or like the person he knew was dead. So I went looking for people like me. I mean, I found gay people, but the bars and the parties, that didn't feel like that was who I was supposed to be. That's when I got thinking, maybe my father was right. Maybe what I thought was his condemnation was a deeper love. Being attracted to men or being with men, that doesn't have to be a part of who I am because it is not in the Lord's image. I think my father is really proud of me now.
Chocolate or strawberry?
Strawberry. What if I'd said chocolate?
I'd have taken strawberry. You been sleeping better?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Lester's finally stopped his snoring. Oh.
How long were you in that hospital?
Which time?
Time before this?
A few months.
What did you do?
It doesn't say in the ex-gay report.
Mark, we take what we do seriously.
I tried to kill myself.
How?
Straight razor. It was my dad's. What do you make of that?
You must have been in a lot of pain.
Didn't feel a thing. I was high at the time.
I meant to do it.
Well, he died instead. Ironic.
You think because of what you did?
I think that's what my mother and my brother would like to believe. But my dad was heading down that road a long time before gay came along. What's the Bible say about asshole parents?
Mark, language. I had a son.
Had?
He died. 8 years ago.
How?
It was an overdose.
How old was he?
He was gay.
So he killed himself?
Oh, I don't think he meant to. But he'd gotten involved with that lifestyle and the drugs. He was very young, so.
Well, why didn't you change him? Do your thing.
Mark. I don't change people. I try to show them how to get closer to Jesus Christ and let them make their own way.
I'm not sure I'll ever know the way.
You know how people who have come close to death talk about walking toward the light? Well, I believe we do the same in life when we walk toward the Lord. And sometimes that light is so bright, it's blinding. But if we have faith and we keep moving forward one step at a time, then we start to see that light of the Lord is within us.
And when we do, it shines out, and it lights our path. And we don't lose our way ever again.
Here I was trying to sound so wise and dignified.
You are.
Well, thank you.
This was nice.
Miles of light explode, drifting off a thing I'd never done before. Watching the crowd roll in, alcohol lights begin, feeling in my bones I'd never felt before.
Good.
Well, I wish Mark had been on our team.
We're all on the same team. Isn't that why we're here?
That was fun today.
Yep.
Lester seems to be coming along.
Slowly.
I just don't understand why you seem to be encouraging Mark and Scott.
What? You don't trust him?
Which one?
Scott.
Don't be ridiculous.
Isn't that what we're striving for here? Healthy, non-sexual friendships between men? I mean, they were playing baseball, for heaven's sake.
Yeah, yes.
Listen, Gail. You're right to be wary. You are. Mark is clever. He's an addict, and addicts are clever, but maybe we should cut him a break. And I guess there's no getting around it.
Around what?
He reminds you of Ryan.
Oh, please. That's not what's going on here. He just needs protecting.
They all do.
Ryan wasn't your son. Please don't use him like that.
I'm sorry.
It's not fair.
Look, maybe we could just let them be for now and try to find their way.
What does it mean?
Yeah.
How many men have you had sex with? More than 10?
Yeah.
You ever in love?
Once.
With a man?
Yeah, it's a long time ago.
Did he know?
He knew.
Gail says I'm blessed because I've never acted on my sexual brokenness. I lived at home my whole life. But the Bible says that if you commit a sin in your mind, it's the same as committing it for real. Do you think that's true?
I don't know, maybe. You?
I hope so. Good night.
Good night, Lester. Sinner.
Ladies and gentlemen, quiet time is
over.
Maybe more. We've been getting the word out. Now, you're going to need, what, is it five?
Six.
Six. Well, this was taken at the social we hosted last March.
Of course, we'll have to invite Maxine Hollister. She's been going out with our Bill for over a year now.
That's wonderful.
Is that Bethany Maurer?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
My, she's gained a little weight, hasn't she? But no, not that she isn't lovely. They're all lovely. I just hope they're free Saturday night.
Well, I shall put in a special word with these six. Well,
thank you, Pastor. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it.
It is important work.
Oh, praise the Lord. Pastor, I'm not sure if Ted has talked to you lately, but the house needs repairs, and the boys can't do everything themselves. Well, had some empty beds, and I just didn't know if the church had apportioned its gifts for the coming months.
Gail, you know, we're happy to support this dance, but we are trying to get our sister church back on its feet. Now, you know that we've always supported Genesis any way that we can.
Yes, you have, and we are so grateful. I was just wondering.
We'll talk again after the dance.
That would be wonderful. Thank you, Pastor. In my soul,
somebody can I got this love that just won't let me go. I got this peace. Hang on. Watching over me. I've got...
Hello?
Yeah.
This is Calvary Hospital calling for Scott Cooper.
Who?
Nurse Marshall of ICU. It's urgent.
Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He guideth me in straight paths for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley
shadow of death,
I will fear no evil, for thou art with me.
Thy
rod and thy staff, they comfort me.
But if a man also lieth with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both of them shall have committed an abomination.
Yeah.
And they shall surely be put to death in blood, Joe. You bought them.
Dad, I love you so much, Dad.
Why did you do this, Scotty? Your life has led you to hell. You're going to hell, and I won't ever see you again.
Could use this. Please take your brother, Henry Cooper. Allow him into your father's kingdom.
Why?
Dad, don't.
Scott's father just passed on.
Hi, Scott. Can we go?
Ted says he's okay.
You never grieved for yours, did you?
For that hypocrite, are you kidding me?
Religion is not to blame, Mark. Fault lies in ourselves.
And nothing worth salvation is ever easy.
Can we pray?
Get back
about an hour ago.
Dad gave me a ride. I'm so sorry.
You hated me.
All right, what happened?
Leviticus.
No, I was probably kidding myself, thinking he was okay with me now, but
I never thought that would be the last thing he ever said to me.
Scott, he's probably delirious on drugs. It happens. Take it from me.
No, why I even care, but I do.
I'm here because I am.
What do you mean?
I came here 2 days after the doctors told me he was dying. I was gonna make it right. And that all made sense for a while. It felt so good.
Well, it does. Huh? Still does?
No. Lately I've been thinking I'm not here for him anymore.
That's good. You're here for you.
That's not what I'm saying. I think about you a lot.
Me too.
Can I grab a smoke?
Yep.
Sorry, I didn't mean to do that.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay. It's not why we're here.
she inside?
I just don't understand your reason for wanting to leave, Lester. I thought you liked it here. You certainly have a lot to offer to all of us. And you know this process takes time. When I have doubts, I know it's the Lord testing my faith. Remember what your father was going through when he brought you here? How heartbroken he was? Now, we don't want to pass our problems back to your father now, do we? When we can handle them here ourselves. Good boy, son.
See them together all the time. Something's got to be done about this. We're barely holding on as it is. We've got to stay on the path.
Why do you always judge Scott so harshly?
Andrews will be here any minute.
You've been on his case from the day he got here.
Ted, sometimes a boy will say all the right things, but underneath you just know he's not really taking Christ into his heart. We have seen that before.
So we need to work harder.
Not if he's at risk to the other boys, we can't save him.
To Mark, you mean?
Mrs. Andrews, it's about love. Discipline and the holy word of God here and in the world. Now, Johnny, you had a chance to meet the residents.
Some.
Did you like them? Were they friendly?
Yeah.
Well, do you think you'd like it here?
He's very shy, and this would be the first time he'd be away from home.
I think you'd like it here, darling, wouldn't you?
Mrs. Tillett, I think what you and your husband have created is a miraculous thing, but this is only the first place we visited, and I'd like some more time to decide if that's okay.
I see.
George, there's nothing wrong with this place. They're all pretty much the same, aren't they?
Well, if you think that, then wait till you see the others. The work we do here is excellent. Not about counter-programming or brainwashing or anything, but the love of Christ.
I'm sorry. My wife didn't mean it that way.
We're all warriors for Jesus. I wish you luck in your search. Bye.
I hate these dances. I don't know why we can't figure out our social lives for ourselves. And it's not that I don't like girls. I like them enough. It's just these forced rituals. The do what we say now. Do-si-do. Round the corner. Here we go. So. Just don't get all disappointed if you don't see me dancing, that's all I'm saying. And it's not that I can't dance. I can. I did inherit that aspect. I can dance, just not with women. Not with those women. I hate it when you look at me like that. Jude's resisting. Jude's not letting his guard down. Jude's not in touch with his true emotions. You try turning tricks to survive. And getting the shit beat out of you regularly at 15. See how well you cope.
Mark, now that the roof is fixed, it might be nice to spend time with some of the others.
The others?
Well, I see you've connected well with Scott, but I think Lester especially would like to talk with you some
more.
He looks up to you.
Is it fine?
All right, everybody ready to have a good time? Thank you, Bill.
You know we sold six of those birdhouses.
That's marvelous for us and the birds, isn't it?
Well, you know what they say. If you build it, they will come.
Did a really nice job handling the funeral.
Well, I'm happy to. Your dad did a lot for me.
Hey, who asked for French?
Oh, me?
Scott tells me you've done amazing things with the business.
Harvey didn't say anything, but I think he's proud of it.
They don't have any secrets.
You want to dance?
Yeah. Yeah, sure. You find me where the music's loud and the melodies are
sweet. In a barroom, in a barroom. Oh, it's a pretty song. We got the dance.
No.
Come on. We got the set, you think?
I'll do whatever I think is necessary. I've had enough of your little games. I thought we meant something to you. That what we were accomplishing meant something. It's embarrassing what you're doing, so stop it.
Why have you never liked me?
No, why?
Scott, this is not the time or place for that.
Ted, don't tell me, tell her.
Scott.
I really wanted you to like me, but I guess it makes me look ridiculous to you, huh?
Let's relax, we're all a little wound up here.
You encourage this behavior.
You're making a scene.
You like it when I get like this, don't you?
Gail.
So what is it, huh? Is it because I didn't show up here in 100 pieces crying on your shoulder, or because I don't remind you of your kid?
You have no right. You are a wolf in sheep's clothing, and I knew it from the moment you set foot in this house. You have never taken Jesus into your heart. You've been pretending all this time, and now you see someone who is just finding his way, and you take advantage of his brokenness.
So are you asking me to go?
I am asking you to stop.
How'd you get back?
Hector gave me a ride. He's gonna take Anna home and come back to pick me up.
Look, slow down, all right? You can spend the night. Tomorrow we can talk about
it. No, fuck this. I can't believe how much time I've wasted in my life, how much I've wasted at this place.
You can work this out.
This is the way it worked out.
Please don't go.
I don't have a choice.
You're not gonna feel this way tomorrow, all right?
That's not what I mean. I know you're used to getting what you want, Mark, but you can't have it both ways.
That's not fair. Okay, I'm finally feeling good about myself. This place is good. These people are good. I think God might be working through me. This thing that's happening between us, that is not his plan.
Are you sure about that? You can walk through that door with me. Good luck, Mark.
Gail's afraid of Scott taking you away. That's why she acted like that.
She did what she had to do.
Do you love him?
What?
I mean, are you in love with him?
Go back to sleep.
I've seen Gail like that before, but this was worse. She can be, what's the word? Ferocious. Which is what I noticed about her before we even met. It was a retreat. I've been sober for 6 months at the time. She offered me work. I needed a job, I took it. Yeah, we hit it off. See, but Ryan was her blind spot. She thought being gay was the whole thing. You fix that, you fix the kid. Genesis came out of that. I'm not convinced that what we do is the only way, but I do know we help. I do know that.
Scott's gone.
That's who I heard in the driveway in the middle of the night. Do the others know?
I guess.
Is there anything else?
Lydia's making breakfast. I'll go help her.
That'd be nice. Mark.
Here.
I know it hurts. But it'll work.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I guess by now, y'all know Scott has left us.
Anybody want to talk about that?
I would.
Nothing lasts, does it? I saw a friendship that was good, and now look at it.
Well, there are paths each of us must take, and they lead in different directions.
What does that mean? Is that supposed to make us feel better?
That's true.
No, I like the way their path was headed. It is not a sin to love thy fellow man. Love is a singularly wonderful experience and should be shared, right?
Isn't that what you told us?
I understand how you feel, Lester. But living through anyone but God is a sure way to a sorrowful life.
But they... Lester! She's right.
Maybe I was just seeing what I wanted to see. Well, you can call me crazy, but you know this time I swore that I wouldn't run, but I can't do it anymore. I can't find my way to stay. I can't see my way.
Did you press your shirt for services?
Not yet. I will.
Don't forget, Mark is reading tomorrow.
Well, I haven't forgotten.
You've got the room until noon.
Be my guest.
Maybe we can try this again sometime.
I don't think so. I mean, look, it's not you. It's just that,
You've got someone at home.
A little more complicated than that.
I hear your 40s are.
But, you know, you got a while, so don't worry.
The reading today is from 1 Corinthians. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I have become a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. But when I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass, darkly. But then, face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even as also I am known. And now, abide faith, hope, and love. These three. But the greatest of these is love. Thank you.
Careful.
Wait, can you believe she actually came? She looked really proud, don't you think?
Maxine looks at me like that a lot. All right, I'm gonna say something here that I know sounds weird coming from me, but I gotta say it. I think Jesus made all this possible. I mean, I know getting here, my brother takes a lot of the credit for that, but I think I really grabbed the ball and I ran with it, right?
Yes, you did.
90 days sober today.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Lester. I call 911.
Mark! Oh, Jesus Christ! Help! 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 Oh, no!
No, please,
They're okay. Oh, my Jesus, God, do something, please. Don't let him die. I'll do anything. Mark, stop it. That's enough.
That's enough. It's all right. All right.
Now, are you gonna come back?
I don't have anywhere else to go. I'm in a mess of things.
Why did you do this?
I don't know. A lot of things, but I saw you two together. And you look so happy. I just wanted to see the two men could have that. Could share that. I know it's not the world's design, but I don't think I could live any other way. I'm sorry.
You know he's proud of you too, right?
Yeah. How'd you like to own it?
On what?
This.
Yeah, in case you haven't noticed, I don't look like a Cooper or a son.
Hey, times change. You want yours.
You serious?
Yep.
I don't know what to say.
Talk to Anna.
Were you skipping town or something?
Let's just say there's something in it for both of us.
Thank you.
Jude called me. I'm surprised you didn't tell me about Lester. Did Gail blame you for him, too?
She was upset.
You mean obsessed?
Did you come here to make me wrong?
No. I came here to see how you were. Bud, looks like you're doing just fine.
Lester's back.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
Mark?
Yeah.
Better come on in.
You're right there.
I'm leaving town. I'll try Arizona for a while, maybe even LA.
Really?
Came to say goodbye.
All right.
And there's something important I want you to know, Gail. I'm not broken.
I don't know why I ever expected you to change.
If a man also lieth with mankind as he lieth with woman, both of them have committed an abomination and shall surely be put to death.
Stop it.
And just four lines before that, this is what it says. Any person who curses his father or mother shall therefore be put to death.
This is not a game, Scott. God is not a game.
Have you ever really listened to those words, Gail? Jesus never said anything about homosexuality.
You don't negotiate your way to salvation. Goodbye, Scott.
Have you ever really looked at yourself? I mean, not through your boys, but looked without anything in the way.
Why are you doing this? What gives you the right to accuse me of anything?
Gail, you're not as strong as you think, and you're not really giving. You can't handle mess. Things need to be neat and tidy for you, but life is not like that. Now, I don't know what it is to lose a child, but I know what it is to have a parent so full of hate that they go to their death damning rather than loving. Is that what you really believe in?
You really think you can convince me that you're going to reason with me and change my mind about what I know is right?
I know love is right. I know love is good.
Mark, let's go inside. Mark.
The other night when I was holding Lester, I felt what I was capable of. I felt the love that I have. I feel that every single time I look at him. I found something here. But it's not here anymore.
That's not true. There's nothing but love for you here. In my heart, in all our hearts, that world out there, the one he wants to take you into, he nearly killed you. Remember how sick you were? You don't want to have that happen again? Think about how far you've come. Don't lose the path. You have the light. You remember what we said that day in the car? When we sat together, just two of us? Remember how that felt? I know who you are. I know how to keep you safe.
Gail?
Ted, stay out of this.
You gotta let him go. He's not Ryan. Ryan is gone.
This is him. We can't let these boys go to sin.
You can't save him, Gail. He's got to do it himself. Just let go.
You let this happen? You saw this and you let this happen?
Maybe I did. It's okay. It's all right. Come on.
need some time to say goodbye to the guys.
I was raised to believe there are consequences in this world. And the judge of our actions, while we'd like to believe it's us, is God. Genesis is an expression of my faith, the labor of my love. I've tried to make myself right with my son through my commitment there. Ryan. Ryan came to me when he was 16 and he said, he was gay. He said he did not want to change, that he did not want to live right by the Lord. And I told him to leave my house because I was not going to have that under my roof. And 5 months later, he was gone. The day I told him to leave was the last time I saw my son. I know I can never, ever bring him back, but if I can help one child from this misery, I will do all in my power to accomplish that. Ryan showed me only his brokenness, but I knew there was a little boy full of love in that frail body. And had I been able to see through my sorrow and judgment and love him as Christ would love him, he could have stayed close. Could have stayed home. And in time, we could have worked for his salvation. But now, I have the chance to save others. To save me.
How would you like me to make out the check?
I felt invisible until you.
In every heart, there is a room, a sanctuary safe
Mark.
And strong to heal the wounds from lovers past until a new.
May the Lord be with you.
I spoke to you.
Oh, he is. He is.
You answered me with no pretense. And still I fear I've said too much. My silence is my self-defense. For every time I've held the rose, it seems I only felt the thorn. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose. And so it goes, and so it goes.